smile. Oh, look, the criminals just blurred it. Look at that. The criminals just blurred the movie here. Look. Look at that, guys. You are nice and clear, and then they just blurred it, the little effers. Right? Hi, Cookie. Come back. Okay, everybody, it's 2 o'clock in the morning, and this is what's going on here. We've got, that's Mommy Cookie. I named her Cookie because I give her cookies, and that is her child. There's another child around here, and they're ravenous. They're eating cat food. Smile! I smile for you too. Yeah, I know. I'm awake at 2 o'clock in the morning. It's absolutely ridiculous. Right? I'm watching raccoons. Thank you, everybody, for your feedback on the videos that I posted. I was going to post another one, but I'll have to wait until tomorrow. Yes, it's 2 o'clock in the morning. It's cold. It's like 34 degrees. It's misty, damp. And I'm sure my criminal neighbors are laughing it up. They won't be laughing it up. In a couple of months, they won't be laughing enough. And also, I have photographs of some additional vandalism to the property. It's very hard to photograph. A little difficult to post because they're mostly photos. But I am going to be documenting this for higher level ups. I'm not going to be even submitting any of the additional vandalism to my property locally. It's all going to be done federally, up the ladder, Attorney General, Congress, and the new administration. And this little critter is really hungry. I like watching raccoons eat. They're so ravenous. Oops, don't fight. There's no fighting. You could hear them crunch, crunch, crunch. That's cat food. Oh, don't fight, guys! Don't fight! There's enough for both of you! I also gave them little Rice Krispie treats. Yeah. And where'd the mommy go? She just disappeared. But anyway, I'm going to sign off for now. I hope everybody's doing well, and we're going to have a the raccoons are going to have a Thanksgiving dinner. Maybe I'll give you an apple tomorrow, guys. Want an apple tomorrow? I'm going to sign off for now. Oh, and I just wanted to say a thank you for the recommendations about calling local butchers around here to see who may have decided to do that to a deer. Although, who knows, there could be many of them around here. But also, in Kentucky, you have to get a license or something. You have to register to unalive a deer. And from what I understand, you're only permitted one per season. So if they have more than one, that means that they're illegally trespassing my property and hunting, which I wouldn't put it past these creatures. So I'm going to have to see if there's any evidence left behind, because you know, when you unalive an animal, they leave remnants behind, sort of like they did on my driveway. So for any of you hunters out there, if you have any other advice about what to look for and where, let me know. I actually did purchase a hunting guide because somebody recommended it that I find out when the deer season was around here. And there are deer that live around here. And I have seen deer ever since I moved here. I haven't seen them recently, maybe because it's getting cold. But thank you for that advice on what to look for. And also something that I didn't think to do or ask the deputy was to get fingerprints off the mailbox. And unfortunately, it was so stinky and bloody on the inside, I cleaned the inside. I didn't clean completely the outside, though. So I might be able to do that. I might be able to, well, actually, if I post this video tonight, those criminals will probably go over there. And it's also very wet here and dewy. So unless I was able to get it this morning, I might not be able to. I mean, I'm not really sure. I'd have to see what the best method is for doing that. But I did clean the inside of the mailbox and the bottom of the mailbox where it was dripping. But no, I did not clean the cover. I did not clean the outside of it. I only cleaned where the blood was. And there was a lot of it. It was stinky. I might still have to do a little bit more cleaning. And I was not able to get the discoloration off the driveway gravel, even with water. So I'm going to have to wait probably for the next heavy rain and maybe sprinkle salt or borax on top of it, something more abrasive. But anyway, if you have any comments about that, again, one, I don't eat meat, just for those who don't know. So it's more repulsive to me because, one, I don't eat meat. I'm a vegetarian. I've been literally for decades. And even if I did eat meat, it wouldn't be a deer. And if I did eat meat, I would have to grow it myself. I would only eat organic. I know that there are a lot of homesteaders out there that grow their own food and stuff. But honestly, you know, after you're raising animals, the thought of, like, eating it just really repulses me. Like, to me, my animals are pets. Like, even these silly raccoons that come here, they're like pets. And the fox is like a pet. Any deer that cross my property, because it is my property and anything that's on it belongs to me, they're my pets. They're my animals. And I have no desire to take their lives. And there's more than enough food to eat without taking the lives of animals. Of course, you know, if we go plunge into a major depression or something, that's another story. But at this point in our society, in our lives, it's completely unnecessary. I mean, this is not to diss any of you carnivores out there. I know that, you know, it's something that people do. It's not something that I do. There are so many ways to get protein, and actually, the way the FDA always describes the food pyramid is totally wrong. You need very little protein in your diet. You actually do need complex carbohydrates and fats and sugars and stuff, but, you know, not the kind of processed foods that are in our general food supply. But, yeah, so it repulses me on several levels. One, it's trespassing, right? It is a federal crime, and yes, I will be contacting the Postmaster General and filing a complaint with him. It's not only trespassing, it's unaliving an animal that I adore, deer, and it repulses me because I don't eat meat. I think it was disgusting. I think the people who did it One is premeditated, and I said this to the deputy just for those who were interested. It is premeditated. Somebody had to think of this idea. It took a lot of effort to carry that stuff. I mean, it's not light. Okay, the innards of an animal are not lightweight. Plus, they had to carry it in something to transport it here, and that's likely why those cars were driving back and forth, the pattern that I noticed. However, just ironically, there was no image of a vehicle stopping for any long period of time, which is what happened with Scarlett and her husband with the pickup truck a week or so ago at 12:03 a.m. when they dumped those dirty toilet papers on my driveway. You know, when a car stops around here, their lights are on. You would see the lights prolonged at the foot of my driveway. I didn't find any of that camera footage, which doesn't mean a damn thing because they're systematically disconnected. However, I did see the pattern of cars driving back and forth at a crazy hour. Now, it's one thing if somebody needed to run out quickly for something and run back. That would be one way and another way. But to be back and forth like six times at different, you know, every 20 minutes, every half an hour, that's surveillance. They wanted to find out if I was still awake, probably, to perform their disgusting task. You know, the coast is clear. Because these are sick Freemason losers. So, and this is what it looks like here at this hour. 2 o'clock in the morning. Yeah, I know, I'm nutso. But thank you for the person that told me to get a spotlight. I do have a spotlight now, and it works like amazingly well. I've actually seen eyeballs shining up on top of the mountain. I don't know if they were these raccoons or an owl or whatever, but I did see that. I saw the reflection of eyeballs in the mountain. But anyway, I'm a little chilly here. I'm going to sign off for now. I hope everybody's doing well, and I just wanted you to see the raccoons and give you a quick update.